Jennifer Arnold and Bill Klein. They're the little couple. Hi, save me, because he thinks I'm crazy today.
Thanks.
Which just kicked off its new season on TLC. Here they are getting ready to introduce their kids to Christmas lights.
Let's go look at Christmas lights. Come on. Put your hat on.
I know. Got them.
Bill is traditionally in charge of the outside, the exterior decorations, and I'm typically in charge of the interior. Until you see the lights on, it's hard to imagine. So, you know, we try to get Will and Zoe excited about, you know, what's gonna happen. And as soon as they hit the button, all these lights are gonna come on. I think Will was very excited to hit the button and make the lights go on.
Press that button right
press
there.
Press it. Ready? No, no. Look at the
just
house.
The one in the middle.
It's gonna be
there
lots
you go.
Of lights.
What does this make me think of?
Christmas Vacation, right?
Chevy I said Chase. Chevy Chase at that
out
moment,
there,
yes.
Things exploding.
Yeah, I'm the
That's
idiot
one of his favorite
father.
Movies.
You're the idiot
yep.
Well, how are you? What's going on, huh?
Doing really well.
Yeah.
Cancer-free over a year now.
Congratulations.
So that,
thank
that's
you.
The first question people have. So you are. You're
yeah,
good.
I am.
You're
I'm
good.
Doing fantastic. All my checkups so far have been fantastic.
Yes. And for people who don't follow closely, your two kids, just tell us briefly about them.
Oh. They're pretty awesome.
Yeah, they are. Will's 5.
Yep.
Zoe's 3.5. They're both in preschool. Oh, they just finished preschool.
Yeah.
Their first
right.
year.
First year.
And they're doing great. Their transition's fantastic.
And you adopted them from where again?
Will's from China, from Inner Mongolia, is right. where he was born. And Zoe's from Mumbai, India.
And yeah. it was important for you. You did search out children who had dwarfism, right? This was what your mission was, right? To fulfill your life with this family?
Absolutely. I think for both of us, you know, our first goal was to become parents.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we
and
tried.
It wasn't easy, right?
It wasn't easy. We tried all routes. And ultimately, when we became more focused on the adoption process, we realized that adopting another child with skeletal dysplasia just made sense. We would know what that's like. We could, you know, hopefully help raise them to deal with, you know, the obstacles that they may face. And we would be able to identify with them. And honestly, we've come to learn that a lot of children with skeletal dysplasia, especially in other countries, are more likely to be given up because of their
right.
skeletal dysplasia.
Well, good yeah. for the two of you. By the way, we're not surprised that you did that.
Yeah. Yeah,
she's
yeah.
telling us. There is a book called Life is Short. No pun intended.
Yeah.
Written right there. No pun intended. And in reading the book, again, not shocking, because the two of you, you're like ambassadors to the world, but you've had a lot of crap in your lives, like everybody else, but even more so. You, I think of you like as the toughest guy in the world. Like, I think of you like a linebacker, you know.
Built like one.
Yeah, but you really were up against it at certain times. They were really yeah. bullying you.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I'm not surprised, but, you know, in grade school up until college, I experienced a lot of bullying. It started with, you know, physical abuse and, you know, being pushed around or pants being raked down in front of kids in the class and stuff like that. Clothes being thrown on top of the lockers in gym, so I'd just be, you know, left to my underwear and a couple of tears. You know, in college it got a little bit more real, I think, you know, where I felt alone. And that was one of my darker moments. And so, you know, we talk a little bit about that in the book. Even after college, trying to get a job, I felt ostracized from, you know, society.
I mean, part of you says, hey, I may be a little person, but it's not going to stop me. I'm going to go succeed in life. And yet there's this other thing hanging over you all the time.
Yeah, well, you know, there's what you want, and then there's the truth of, you know, what everybody else perceives to be your limitation, or, you know, you as the weaker of the herd. And so you have to overcome all that, and you can't let everybody else tell you what's right.
And in the book, you talk about you standing on the ledge, right?
I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was outside the ledge in my dormitory. I was contemplating taking that last leap, and you know, of course, what brought me back in was mostly family.
Mm-hmm.
My dad, you know, a force to be reckoned with as a kid, I was a little afraid that even in the afterlife he would somehow get to me and yell at me about it. And my mom, I know she'd be heartbroken forever. So
now think about it. If you had done it, all of this wouldn't have happened.
Never would have had the love of my life.
Yeah, it's a lesson for everybody.
Yeah.
All right, now you, what were you encountering growing up?
So I think, you know, as I went through trying to write our story, I realized that I did not have nearly the amount of bullying that Bill had, although in the sort of, I think when you're a girl, there's a different type of bullying that happens.
Mm-hmm.
Had to go through some of that, but I think the thing that stuck out for me the most was, you know, going through all the surgeries that I went through.
Yes.
And how you know, hard that can be for a child, and sort of self-reflecting, you know, how that had an impact on me. And I mean, like Bill said, I was so fortunate that I had two parents that made sure I not only got the best medical care possible, but that they helped support me to grow and be strong and to
I'm thinking
overcome
first
those
of,
things.
Teenage girls.
Oh, yeah.
End of subject.
Yes, yes, it's a rough.
All right, so, they make movies, basically.
Yes.
So there you are in school, and you had, you know, you had friends. That was an easy part. But at the social events, at the dances, you'd find yourself in the end what?
I mean, I was always the one who was the party planner, and that was my way of sort of making sure I got out there. I was socializing and trying to make the best of it and have a good time.
So
but
you were protecting yourself. You knew how to protect yourself.
Yes.
Because you had been through the thing where, you know, the dances would start and you'd be sitting off in a corner somewhere,
yes,
right?
Yeah. I mean, I would always try and look busy and like I had something to do or find somebody else to chat with. But it was hard when you saw all of your friends going out there and coupling up and dancing to the slow
dance. I want to make a point. I think your book is actually very inspiring. And
full of joy.
And listen, there are 1,000 books come out a week, and most of them, you know, enough. But I'll tell you what's great in this book. You have unique lives, and just the story of your lives is great. But everything that you have gone through, we've all gone through.
Yeah.
You're looking at it through the prism of little people is one thing. We've all had those same exact moments in different ways. And there's such a lesson for all of us to learn about, hey, this is only today.
Yep.
Tomorrow's another day.
Yep.
Tomorrow's going to be good. The next day after may not be so good, but the day after that is better.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's what it's all about. I mean,
You still love him?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Does he still love me?
I don't know. Let's ask him.
Of course. Yeah. I love my wife more than anything.
Also in the book is the story of how you actually met and sort of met and didn't meet and met and all of that. That goes on through.
It's wonderful. It's
great to have you here. Little
Thank
Couple
you.
Airs Tuesdays on TLC.
And well, those kids are running around that house. You showed a quiet clip.
Yeah, that was pretty tame right there.
That's the book a crazy house.
Life is short, no pun intended. Love, laughter, and learning to enjoy every moment. Good to see you guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.